Hey guys, Nerdking101 here. Quick One Piece video I wanted to do that covers and discusses some of the events and criticisms following the release of One Piece Chapter 1044. I don't have a lot of time to record this because I'm actually leaving very soon to go on a work trip, but I did want to get this audio recorded before I left. So if the video is a bit shorter than some of my other discussion videos, that's why. Now, what I wanted to address is a single major criticism that I've seen of the chapter. I was actually going to do a video addressing all the criticisms and the foreshadowing and addressing all the plot holes people are talking about, but I actually don't have time to record a video like that at the moment. So instead, I just want to do a quick video addressing one plot hole I've seen people bringing up or one criticism, which is why didn't the world government just kill Luffy sooner? Why didn't they go after him, like, immediately when he first defeated Arlong? Now, just to get it right out of the way, the reason they didn't do it before that was because they didn't know Luffy existed. Now, I'm sure they knew that Garp had a grandson, possibly, but they definitely didn't know what devil fruit he had. Garp would just not tell them that. Garp was keeping a lot of secrets to protect Ace and Luffy. And as for why they didn't hunt him down earlier in the story, well, I think it's actually pretty obvious. Now, a lot of people seem to be forgetting that the Five Elders are the leaders of the world, meaning they're constantly dealing with stuff that we probably don't even know about. We see the significant stuff, but I'm sure they're also dealing with a lot of political stuff involving various kingdoms and alliances, and maintaining the world government as a whole, and maintaining the balance of power. They're also constantly dealing with events involving the Yonko. I'm sure the Yonko aren't just tiddling their thumbs waiting for Luffy. I'm sure they were doing things pre-time skip, and I'm sure that the world government was actively moving to undermine the efforts of the Yonko, especially Yonko like Big Mom and Kaido, who seemingly want to obtain the One Piece, which they don't want to happen. Now, this is what's important here. If you're the leader of an entire massive organization like the world government, you're not going to hear about every small-time criminal. Now, yes, Luffy was a big deal in the East Blue. He defeated all their major pirates, including Arlong, and was given a bounty of 30 million berries. But my question is, what does that equate to in the real world? Does that equate to committing one major crime in New York City and becoming the most wanted man in New York State? Now, that's a big deal. There's a manhunt for you. I'm sure the police are charging after you all the time, but I don't think the police are going to be calling up the President of the United States, somebody like Joe Biden, and asking him for help or what they should do about some small-time criminal in New York City. They're not going to do that. The Marines probably have some sort of protocol in place for when a pirate becomes a certain level of bounty or a certain threat level. That is when they are brought to the attention of the Gorosei, or the Five Elder Stars. It could even be as simple as the Gorosei don't find out about things until they're worth being in the newspaper worldwide. Like, why would they be reporting or dealing with Luffy in the East Blue? He's of no consequence to them in comparison to other threats. They probably don't even know his name, and if they do, they probably just heard that he defeated Arlong, and they probably weren't told what devil fruit he had. Because why would somebody be sent to Marijo's or to a transponder sale to call the Gorosei and be like, so there's this kid, he defeated a couple no-name pirates in the East Blue, and he had gum rubber powers? Like, why would that happen? Why would that be reported to them? They're too important, and they have better things to do than worry about East Blue level criminals. So I would guess the first time he was ever brought to their attention in any way was after he defeated Crocodile. Now, they may not even know he has the Gumu no Mi yet, because they probably haven't had a conversation with anybody who has fought Luffy before. They may be aware of it at this point, but I doubt it. I think they would first become aware that Luffy had the Gumu Gumu no Mi after the events of Enies Lobby. If remember, after he defeats Crocodile, they probably still haven't looked into him too heavily. But then, of course, the Straw Hats don't do anything in the real world in the next arc. Instead, they go to the sky to go to Skypiea and defeat Enaru. I think after Enies Lobby, after they break into Enies Lobby and declare war on the world government, would be when the Gorosei would finally hear from somebody, Luffy has the Gumu Gumu no Mi. That would probably be the point when somebody would go to the Gorosei and they would have a conversation about the fact that this Luffy kid is an actual threat, and they would ask for like a rundown on him. Like, what are his powers? What can he do? Why does he keep getting away from you? And somebody would say, he has the Gumu Gumu no Mi, he can stretch his body like rubber, and the world government, the Gorosei, would be like, crap, that's really bad. Because the important thing to note is the fact that the Gumu Gumu no Mi is a big deal, the fact that it's incredibly important, is a secret. The secret is not just that it actually is another devil fruit given a fake name, the fact that the Gumu Gumu no Mi is important is a secret in and of itself. Meaning most of the Marines, probably all of the Marines, I don't think this is something the Navy is even aware of, probably don't know. They probably have no idea that the Gamu Gamu no Mi is important. So why would they report it to the Gorosei in any situation right away? It probably got reported to them in some mundane report about Luffy when they were being told about his threat level and trying to decide what to do about him after any lobby. They hear about it and they're probably like, oh no, that's bad. Why didn't you tell us that sooner? And then the poor Marine who told them that is probably like, why would we tell you that? Is it irrelevant? Is the Gamu Gamu no Mi important? It seems like a pretty crappy devil fruit. And they probably kill the guy and be like, now what do we do? Then Kuma is sent to deal with the Straw Hats, but he's clearly working with dragons, so he lets them go. Then they travel to the Bodhi Archipelago, where Luffy punches a celestial dragon, and they're probably thrilled they have an excuse to send an admiral after him without raising any strange suspicion, so they send Kizaru to kill him and capture the Straw Hats. They then escape thanks to the help of Kuma and Rayleigh. They then have no idea where on the planet Luffy is until he shows up in Marineford. Now, the important thing to note here is, once again, nobody there besides maybe Sengoku, and I don't believe he even knows that Luffy having the Gamu Gamu no Mi is a big deal. So he was still not their top priority. Their top priority was, of course, still executing poor Gusty Ace. Now, they all did try to kill Luffy, but once again, they just failed. They did actively try, especially at the end, with everything that they had to kill Luffy, but then at the end of the war, Shanks showed up. There was never really a moment where they could have done it. They were certainly trying their damnedest to do it at the opportunities they had, but they were still prioritizing something else, killing Ace. It's honestly pretty obvious to me that the reason they failed to get the Gamu Gamu no Mi from Luffy during this entire story is because the people that he'd been fighting had no idea it mattered. So strategically, they weren't able to prioritize defeating Luffy fully, because it seems like the only people who knew that this was a big deal were the Gorosei. And it feels to me like it's not something they can really tell the Navy to do, because they don't want to arouse any suspicion around it. They don't want it to make it look weird. They can't very well just send three admirals to kill Luffy in the East Blue, because even the admirals may turn around and be like, why are you sending us to the East Blue? This is weird. Garp would probably turn around and say something at that point. He's Garp's grandson, he's the son of Dragon. They probably don't just want to send a ton of admirals out him right away, because if he thinks they're being incredibly unfair or be attacked by the admirals is unjustified, what if Garp gets involved and tries to defend Luffy? But there's a lot of politics going on here, and they all really come back to the fact that the Gorosei is really trying to hide this devil fruit, meaning the commanders who are giving the orders during all these big battles that Luffy has been involved with involving the Navy, they can't give reliable orders because they're missing a massive chunk of information about what the goal is here. They don't even know what the real goal is. They think Luffy's just some other pirate. They don't realize their top priority should just be murdering him. Then, of course, there was the time skip where Luffy disappeared for 2 years. He came back out of nowhere and went to Fifth Man Island, where they would be unable to interfere. Then he accidentally bumped into Smoker and Tashiki at Punk Hazard, but even if they knew they needed to capture Luffy and that needed to be a priority, one, in character, they wouldn't have done it, because saving the children was a priority for both of them. And Smoker and Tashiki have their own senses of justice that I think would equate to them not wanting to just murder Luffy in cold blood, like assassinate him when he's down over his devil fruit. I just don't think that's something Smoker or Tashiki would ever consider even being a part of. It's too dark and too much like the kind of stuff they did with Rouge for them. Because Smoker and Tashiki actually kind of like Luffy on some level, and they have a sense of morality. So that's also the thing, they wouldn't have done it. Then they go to Dressrosa, where they have the same problem. Fujitora lets Luffy go because of his own sense of justice. Well, we could argue that maybe if he had known the truth about Luffy, he wouldn't have done that. But honestly, knowing the character of Fujitora, I think he felt very strongly about his convictions, and I think he would have let Luffy go even if he knew about the reason that Gamu Gamu no Mi was dangerous. And then they went to Whole Cake Island and Zoe, which had nothing to do with the world government. The world government was certainly not going to follow Luffy into the territory of Big Mom. And then, of course, now they're at Wano, and I think now they're having a moment where they're facing the reality that Luffy could possibly awaken the fruit. Because the world government doesn't seem to be overly concerned with the human-human fruit model, Nika, in general. They seem to be more concerned with it awakening. Now, they certainly want to keep it out of enemy hands, and would have preferred to have just captured it and for Shanks not to have stolen it, but I don't think they're super worried about it until they realize there was a chance Luffy could awaken it. Because considering the fact that Delafruit has avoided them for 800 years, I think it's very likely there have been past users of the human-human fruit model, Nika. Meaning, that there have probably been other users who had just failed to awaken it. They even said nobody had awakened the Devil Fruit in 800 years. So at points when Luffy wasn't directly in front of them and he was in places like Yonko territory, like Whole Cake Island, I don't think they were willing to start a war with Big Mom over it. Like, this is a big deal, but they even say in this chapter, in 1044, it's going after the Model Nika, it's going after Straw Hat, worth incurring the wrath of Kaido or Big Mom? Is it worth incurring the wrath of a Yonko? At the end of the day, they also need to maintain the balance of the world so they can maintain perfect control of it. Now, I think this is the moment, during Wano, where they realize, if Luffy and Kaido are fighting, if Luffy manages to awaken the fruit during the fight, this is the moment it's going to happen. While he's fighting Kaido, who is probably the strongest character alive right now, or at least one of them, and they're probably saying to themselves, if Kaido and Luffy fight, and if Luffy awakens the Devil Fruit, we will be in a lot of trouble. And I think this is the moment where they're kind of realizing he's powerful enough that this could actually happen now. He's on the level of power where he could reach the level that Joy Boy was at when Joy Boy awakened the Devil Fruit that Joy Boy or somebody else had 800 years ago. I'm not going to say it for sure Joy Boy, but somebody 800 years ago that was fighting on Joy Boy's side or on the side of the Ancient Kingdom, somebody who was fighting against the world government, definitely had the human fruit Model Nika. I'm sure of it. That's why they're so afraid of it. It is incredibly powerful and incredibly dangerous. And I don't think it's that they're so much afraid of how powerful it makes the person, but it's the ability that they have to draw others to them, to put smiles on people's faces, and to become a warrior of liberation, because they're obviously afraid of the world being liberated from their own rule. But it probably wasn't until this moment, during the fight with Kaido, where they realized, he's too close to awakening it. It's too much of the possibility. Guys, he needs to die now. So they decided, in a moment of pure panic, basically, they looked at their options and they said, this is too close to happening. We've taken a lot of chances letting Luffy get away. We've made a lot of mistakes. It was clearly a mistake. We never thought Luffy would get to this point. They were probably really banking on Luffy dying to one of the Yonko or to one of the warlords, or to one of the admirals. They were kind of just hoping Luffy would just die like all the other users did at some point, or just fail to awaken it. And I think now, once he reached Kaido level, they were like, okay, he's clearly not going to lose, and that there's a chance he's going to win, and he's so powerful, and Kaido kills him, the fruit may awaken anyway. So we really don't have a choice. And then they weighed their options. What is worse, the Devil Fruit awakening, or fighting Kaido? And they decided that it would be better to fight Kaido and kill Luffy. That was the conclusion they came to, because they were aware that this would be an act of war against the Beast Pirate. But I think up until now, especially when Luffy started getting involved with the Yonko, I think they very much were looking at him from the perspective of really hoping one of the Yonko would kill him before he got to the level where he could awaken the Devil Fruit. Yeah, I think they were at the point, eventually, when they really started to panic, probably when he started getting involved with Big Mom, where they were like, but if we kill him, we may be seen as interfering in the business of one of the Yonko, and we don't want to do that. They don't want to get involved in the business of Yonko, like Big Mom or Kaido. So I think they kind of just been avoiding it and hoping he would die, and I think when he didn't, they just said, okay, Cypherfall Zero, kill Luffy. And now the Devil Fruit has awakened, and they have to deal with the consequences. I actually think it's actually very interesting, because I think we're finally seeing the secrecy of the world government really bite themselves in the ass. They've been hiding the fact that how dangerous Luffy's power is from everyone, and because of that, they've never really been able to fully mobilize their forces to take him out. If they had just been honest with the Navy, maybe they could have had the Navy just kill Luffy during Marineford. Maybe they could have said killing Luffy is more important than killing Ace. That would have been their opportunity to do it, to call Sengoku and say, let Whitebeard save Ace, we don't care, just kill Luffy. But they didn't want to do that, because they didn't want to tell people about the human fruit Model Nika. And I think it's really fascinating to see that the cracks are starting to form in the world government. We're starting to see how 800 years of lying and hiding things is causing things to fail. Because there is a downside to 5 people lying to the entire organization. The downside is they're trying to keep these secrets guarded so closely. They're trying to keep everyone from asking certain questions so hard that things like this are happening. And I think that's really what it boils down to. Logistically, it was impossible to prioritize catching Luffy without raising awareness to how important his Devil Fruit was. Because no matter how you did it, up until he was powerful enough to explain why you were prioritizing him, it would have looked really weird if you were like, Admiral, send the entire Navy to the East Blue to kill Luffy. Now, you may argue why they didn't send the Sniper Pole to kill Luffy. Well, because he's related to Garp and Dragon, as I said earlier. That wouldn't go under Garp's nose. Garp was probably keeping an eye on Luffy. He may have been doing that. Also, still, even then, they would still have not have known about him back then to, enough to deal with him. They probably didn't know. Like, you have to remember, three times it happened in a span of a few months. By the time they find out about the Devilfruit, it's probably too late. They probably don't know until, like, after any lobby. And then they send Kuma. Kuma failed. And by the time they end up hearing about where he is again, where they know where he is, or they can send someone to kill him, they send Kizaru, and Kizaru failed. At that point, they're probably just like, what are we going to do? We don't know where he is half the time. So yeah, this video obviously ended up being like 15 minutes, which was not my intention. I need to go to sleep. I'll try to edit it at some point this week. If I have time, I probably won't. Hopefully I can have this up at least before the unofficial scan for the next chapter comes out, or at least before the spoilers. I don't know. I'll try my best. Maybe we'll go up super unedited. Maybe that's why you'll see the video will just be a couple images. I don't know. But guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Tell me your thoughts on why the government didn't just kill Luffy in the comment section down below. Also, if I sound a little off, I apologize. I have a terrible canker sore. But above all else, have a great day.